Hello learners, we are moving to special purpose books. In this session, you will learn meaning of purchases book and meaning of purchase returns book. Then we will prepare purchases book and purchase returns book. You have studied journal. And journal can be divided into different books. Or different journals. Why we are dividing? In order to get information separately, we are dividing journals. In the case of purchases book, you will get all information relating to purchase in the same book. In the case of sales book, you will get all information relating to sales in that particular book itself. So, to get information separately, special books are prepared. Another feature or another importance why we are preparing this book is, according to the nature of the transaction, we will write in the concerned book. If it is bills receivable, then it is written in the bills receivables book. So, the nature is bills receivable. In the case of purchases, it will be recorded in the purchases book. So, special purpose books are prepared as per the nature of the transactions. And these special purpose books are also known as subsidiary books. And these are a type of journals. Coming to the first type of special purpose book, that is the purchases book. Purchases book is a book of original entry. And in this book, we will record only credit purchases of goods. Credit purchases of goods only will be recorded in the purchases book. Cash purchases are recorded in the cash book. So, it is not recorded in the purchases book. Credit purchase of assets are not recorded in the purchases book. Where you will write the asset purchase? Asset purchase are recorded in the journal proper. You have to write the purchases book according to the format, that is with date, invoice number, name of supplier, ledger folio, details and amount columns. In the date column, year, month and date of the transactions are recorded in chronological order, that is in the order of occurrence, in the order of dates. Then coming to invoice number. In the second column of the purchases book, you have to write the invoice number. Third column, name of the supplier. Name of the supplier from whom the goods were purchased is written in this column. Then comes the ledger folio column. Here, the page number of the ledger book in which supplier's account is maintained is written. The amount in respect of each article is written in the details column. If the seller has allowed a trade discount, it is also deducted in the details column. Amount, last column. It records a net amount payable to that concerned supplier. Record the following transactions for the month of August 2014 in the purchases book of Messrs. Harsha Electronics. 2014 August 5th, purchase from Messrs. Naresh Electronics 5 color TV at ₹12,500 per piece. Trade discount on all items at 20%. On August 10th, bought from Messrs. Capital Electronics 20 tape recorders at ₹1,650 per piece. Trade discount 10% on purchase. Then you have to write as a heading in whose book you are opening the purchases book. Books of Messrs. Harsha Electronics. Then you have to write purchases journal or purchases book. Draw the format with date column, invoice number column, name of supplier column, ledger folio, details and amount. Date column will start with the year, then month and date. 2014, August 5th. Invoice number 250 in that column. Naresh Electronics is the name of the supplier. What items you have purchased, that is Harsha Electronics have purchased 5 color TV at rupees 12,500. That is also written in the name of the supplier column. Then its calculation is written in detail in the details column. 5 into 12,500, 62,500. 62,500 into 20 by 100 will give you 12,500. So, 62,500 minus trade discount 12,500 will give you 50,000 and that will come in the outer column. That is the amount column. Then next date, August 10th, invoice number 826, name of the supplier Capital Electronics, 20 tape recorders at rupees 1650 will be written in the name of the supplier column itself. Then its calculation in the details column, 20 into 1650 amount came to 33,000. Trade discount of 10%. So, deduct 10% of 33,000. It will come to 3,300. 33,000 minus 3,300. It will come to 29,700. Some more transactions are there in the Harsha Electronics. They purchased on August 17th from Messrs. East Electronics 15 stereos at rupees 4000 per piece, 2 color TV at rupees 10,500 per piece, trade discount at 5%. Then on August 25th, purchase from Messrs. Naresh Electronics, 10 small TV at rupees 1200 per piece and 3 color TV at rupees 12,000 per piece and trade discount 10%. Similarly, one more transaction is given on August 30th. Coming to the preparation of the purchases book, it is a continuation of the earlier entries. In the books of Messrs. Harsha Electronics, heading and purchases journal or purchases book. 2014, August 17, East Electronics 15 stereos at rupees 4000. In the name of the supplier column and what they have purchased, that also will be written in that column. Its calculation in the details column. So, 15 into 4000, that will come to 60,000. 2 color TV at rupees 10,500, 2 into 10,500, 21,000. So, total purchases from East Electronics came to rupees 81,000. Then, its 10%, that is 81,000, will be the total purchase from East Electronics. For this 81,000, you have to calculate trade discount of 5%. 81,000 into 5 by 100, 4,050. 81,000 minus trade discount 4,050 will give you 76,950. And on August 25th, again, in the name of the supplier column, Naresh Electronics, another supplier, 10 small TV at rupees 1200, 10 into 1200 in the details column, and Harsh Electronics bought 3 color TV at rupees 12,000 from Naresh Electronics. So, 3 into 12,000 gives 36,000. So, 12,000 plus 36,000 will give you 48,000. Less trade discount 10%, 48,000 into 10 by 100 will give you 4,800. 48,000 minus 4,800 will give you 43,200. Then, August 30, from Pavitra Electronics, Harsha Electronics purchased 20 video cassettes at rupees 150. 20 into 150, 3,000. As the net amount in the amount column. When you add all the purchases, that is including the previous two more transactions, you will get a total of 2,02,850. So that amount will be written in the amount column after totaling, and in the same line in the name of the supplier column you will write purchases account, and date you will put last date of that particular month, that is August 31, purchases account 2,02,850. So you have prepared the purchases book of Harsha Electronics. Coming to the posting of purchases journal into ledger. Posting from the purchases book is done daily to 11 suppliers' accounts on the credit side with the invoice amount at the end of the month. The grand total of the purchases book is posted to the debit side of purchases account in the ledger and written in the particulars column sundries as per purchases book. You have studied in the previous question the name of some of suppliers. So, how you will post after writing the entries in the purchases book? In the purchases book, you have already written Naresh Electronics, that is Harsha Electronics purchased materials from Naresh Electronics. So, you have to post in the Naresh Electronics account. Messrs. Naresh Electronics, their account will be opened. And in that account on the credit side you will post by purchases on which date, that date will be written in the date column. So on August 5th one purchases amounting 50,000. On August 25th also Harsha Electronics purchased goods from them for rupees 43,200. Then Messrs. Capital Electronics. From them also Harsha Electronics purchase goods. So on the credit side we will post by purchases 29,700 amount. Then East Electronics, from them also Harsha Electronics purchased materials. So on the credit side of Messrs. East Electronics account you will post by purchases amount in the amount column and date in the date column. Purchases account debit to East Electronics, that will be the entry. Always purchases will have debit, that we have already studied in the journal. Pavitra Electronics, their account will be opened and on the credit side you will write by purchases, date and amount in the respective columns. Then you have to open purchases account. Now we have already opened suppliers account. Then one more account is to be opened, that is the purchases account. In the purchases account, you will post on the debit side. That is, purchases account will have a debit always. So, you are posting on the debit side of the purchases account. You have to post on the debit side of the purchases account. What you will post? That is, you have to write sundries as per purchases book in the particulars column and amount in the amount column, total purchases will come here. And date, last date of that particular month, you have already written in the purchases book, August 31st. So, we have posted the date here also, August 31st. Purchase returns journal. Return of goods purchased on credit will be recorded in the purchases returns journal. Now we have studied purchases journal, then coming to purchases returns journal, here return of goods purchased on credit will be written. Purchases returns journal is also known as returns outward book. Whatever is coming inside is returning, so returning outward. It is purchase returns journal is also known as purchases returns book. Why we are returning goods? In most of the cases, goods may be returned due to goods are not as per the sample. Sometimes goods may be of inferior quality. Some of the goods may be damaged in transit. These can be the reasons why the company is returning goods to the concerned supplier. While preparing purchase returns journal, you have to prepare a debit note, and this is prepared by the purchaser of goods in duplicate. The account of the supplier of goods is debited with the amount of goods returned. That is debit note. The account of the supplier of goods is debited with the amount of the goods returned. A debit note is prepared by the purchaser of goods in duplicate. Original copy is sent to the supplier and duplicate copy is kept by the buyer. Purchase returns journal or purchase returns book also have a format, that is with date, debit note number, name of supplier, ledger folio column, details and amount column. Date. In this column, year, month and date of the transactions are recorded in the order of occurrence, that is in chronological order. Debit note number is written in the debit note number column. Name of the supplier is the third column. In this column, name of the supplier from whom the goods were purchased is written. Then comes the ledger folio column. The page number of the ledger book on which supplier account is prepared is recorded. In the details column, details of the goods returned to the supplier is recorded. In the amount column, you have to write the amount of total goods returned to the supplier. Here is a question which will give information of Messrs. Harsha Electronics, who has returned some goods to Messrs. Capital Electronics. What they have returned? 5 tape recorders at ₹1,650 per piece and trade discount at 10% on purchases. How you have to write purchase returns book or purchase returns journal? Books of Messrs. Harsha Electronics, that should be your heading. And purchases returns journal, that also should come. Or purchases returns book, you have to write. Then with date, debit note number, name of supplier, ledger folio column, details and amount. Date you have to write as per the instructions, that is 2014, that is year comes first, then month and then date. Debit note number you have to write. Name of the supplier to whom you are returning the goods. Capital Electronics. What you have returned? 5 tape recorders at ₹1,650. So its detailed calculation will be written in the details column. 5 into 1650 will give you 8,250 and trade discount of 10% is written. 8,250 into 10 by 100 will give you 825. 8250 minus 825 will give you 7,425. This amount should be written in the amount column or outer column. Then here only one transaction is there. Even if there is one transaction or if there are many transactions, you have to total purchases book, purchase returns book, sales returns book, etc. So here only one transaction. So you have to total and write it once again, 7,425. In the same line, in name of the supplier's account column, you have to write purchases returns account and date. Last date of that particular month, August 31st. Posting of purchase returns journal into ledger. Monthly total of purchase returns journal is credited to the purchase returns account in the ledger. Supplier account to whom the goods are returned is debited with the net amount of goods returned. You have already written question relating to the purchases returns. So from that question you have returned the material to Messrs. Capital Electronics. When you are opening the name of the supplier's account, that is Messrs. Capital Electronics account, how you have to post this purchase returns? Messrs. Capital Electronics account will be opened with date column, particulars column, ledger folio, amount column on debit side and on the credit side. Then on the debit side, you will post purchase returns with the amount and date in the respective columns. Always purchases will have debit balance. So, purchases returns will have credit balance. Sales will have credit balance. Sales returns will have debit balance. These are the basic things. So, accordingly, if you are keeping it in your mind, you can easily post this entry in a proper way without creating much mistake. Then you have to open purchases returns account also. Name of the supplier's account will be opened, then purchases returns account will be opened. And on the credit side, you will post buy sundries as per purchases returns book. Date and amount in the respective columns. Enter, here is a question, like enter the following transactions in the special books of Messrs. Mohit Stationery Mart. Special books, only that much they have mentioned. In the books of Mohit Stationery Mart on June 2014 and prepare respective books or prepare purchases book and purchase returns book. On June 1st, they have given a transaction relating to purchase from Messrs. Seema Stationers. Then on June 12th also, bought from Messrs. Nisha Paper Mart. That means these are the transactions relating to purchases. So, whether you will write in the purchases book or in the purchase returns book, definitely you have to write in the purchases book. So, you have to open purchases book and you have to write the heading in the books of Messrs. Mohit Stationery Mart. Then, which book you are preparing, that also you have to write, purchases book or purchases journal. Date in the respective column, invoice number in that column, and the name of the supplier, Seema Stationers and Nisha Paper Mart. In respective dates you have to write. Then what you have purchased, 50 paper rim at rupees 100, 60 simple books at rupees 20. So, 50 into 100, 5000, 60 into 20, 1200, 100 packet pencil at rupees 50, 100 into 50, 5000. So, 5000 plus 1200 plus 5000 will give you 11000. That total amount will come in the amount column. Another one more purchase is done by this organization. So, that is from which supplier? Nisha Paper Mart. 200 files at rupees 12, 200 into 12, 2400. Here trade discount of 5% is given in the question. So, we have deducted 2400 into 5 by 100 will give you 120. That is, trade discount should be deducted from the amount 2400. 2400 minus 120 will give you 2280. Some more transactions are there in this question. So, we are moving to that. Purchase from Messrs. Bensel Stationers as per invoice and 500 drawing paper is purchased, 10 packet pencil color is purchased, trade discount at 5% is written in the question. June 23rd, goods are returned to Messrs. Nisha Paper Mart. So, you have to prepare two books here. One purchases book and another purchase returns book. In the purchases book or in the purchases journal, you are writing Bensel Stationers because they are the supplier of 500 drawing paper at rupees 4 and 100 packet pencil at rupees 20. 500 into 4, 2000. 100 into 20, 2000. So, 2000 plus 2000, 4000. Less trade discount at 5%. 5 by 100 into 4000 will give you 200. 4000 minus 200 will give you 3800. So, this is also a transaction coming in the purchases book. Then we have one more transaction relating to purchase returns. So, we have to open purchases returns book also in this question. Some more transactions relating to the purchase. Messrs. Stationery Zone. 200 packet pens are purchased. Trade discount at 10%. June 27, purchase from Messrs. Sumit Paper Mart. 100 packet watercolor and 50 packet paint brushes. Here also trade discount is mentioned. So, we have to prepare one purchase returns in the previous slide and two purchases of this slide. So, in the purchases journal, you are writing Sumit Paper Mart, 100 packet watercolor at rupees 50, date in the respective column, invoice in the respective column. Then coming to the details that you have to write in the name of the supplier column, and you have to write in that column what all materials that this concern has purchased. 100 into 50, 5000, 50 into 40, 2000. So 5000 plus 2000, 7000. Trade discount at 10% is given in the question. 7000 into 10 by 100 will give you 700. 7000 minus 700 will give you 6300. Net amount will come in the amount column. Then from Honda File Trader, 200 plastic files have been purchased at rupees 25. 200 into 25, 5000 rupees. Trade discount at 10%. 5000 into 10 by 100, 500 will come. 5000 minus 500 will come to 4500. So, considering the previous transaction also, purchases book will have a total of 46,080. And in the name of the supplier column, you have to write purchases account. And in the date column, you have to write last day of that particular month, June 30, purchases account, 46,080. We have not, earlier we didn't open the purchases returns book. Now we have to open the purchases returns book for this question. Because they have returned some goods to Nisha Paper Mart as well as to Bensel Stationers. Heading purchases returns journal or purchases returns book. Date, debit note number, name of supplier, ledger folio column, details, amount. 2014, June 22nd, debit note number column, and then coming to name of supplier, we have returned goods to Nisha Paper Mart, 50 files at rupees 12, 50 into 12, 600. Less trade discount at 5%, 600 into 5 by 100, 30. Net amount 570, that is 600 minus 30 will come in the outer column. Then from Bensel Stationers also, we have purchased certain materials and we have returned to Bensel Stationers. What items we have returned? 50 packet pencil, color at rupees 20. So, 50 into 20,000, trade discount 5%, 1000 into 5 by 100, that will come to 50. 1000 minus 50 will give you 950, net amount 950 will come in the amount column. Then, when you total all the things, 1520 is the total, and purchases returns account, you have to write in the name of the supplier column, and in the date column, you have to write last date of that particular month, June 30th, purchases returns account, 1520. So, dear learners, in this session, we have studied the meaning of purchases book and purchase returns book. And we came to know how to prepare the purchases book and purchase returns book. You have understood that purchases book, that in the purchases book, you will record only the purchase of goods. That is, asset purchase will not be recorded, cash purchase will not be recorded. And cash purchase will be written in the cash book. Asset purchase will be written in the journal proper. Then we understood the preparation of the purchases book preparation and purchases returns book preparation. Hope you understood this session very well. Thank you.